What happens if you click a bad link? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's an honest question I get from time to time. What do you do if you click on a phishing link? Am I screwed? It depends. It depends on exactly what happens, and more importantly, it depends on what you did next. Most of the time, clicking on a link just brings up a web page. With attempted phishing, the web page may look like a site you might recognize, but it won't be that site at all. For example, the link may claim to be PayPal, and the page you land on may look like PayPal, even though it's not PayPal at all. 9 times out of 10, it'll look like a sign-in page, and you'll be asked to sign in to the account the page is trying to look like. With our PayPal example, that means you'll see what looks like a PayPal sign-in page, and you'll be asked to enter your PayPal credentials. Don't. As long as you don't try to sign in, not much has happened. Your browser's displayed a web page, that's all. Let me show you an example of what I mean. I do not have something that sets up this fake example. I don't have a fake PayPal page, but I can show you what it means to click on a malicious or fake link. From a previous article on hovering over a link to see where it goes, I have this link to eBay. If you take the time to hover over it, you'll see in the lower left-hand corner, it tells me that, yeah, it's going to a completely different website. Let's say you ignore that. Let's say you just say, oh great, I need to go to eBay, and you click. And sure enough, you went to something else. In our example here, this is not eBay. If this were a malicious site, the page we would have landed on would have looked like eBay. In fact, it probably would have looked like an eBay sign-in screen. And that's the trick. As long as you don't try to sign in, not much has happened. Your browser displayed a web page, just like this one, and that's all that happened. My recommendation is that you immediately close the tab containing the fake page. How do you know it's a fake page? Well, if you see in the address bar of my example here, we clicked on eBay.com. This URL in the address bar has nothing to do with eBay. That tells you, you were misled. You clicked on something expecting eBay, and you ended up on a completely unrelated web page. Close the tab. Now, if, on the other hand, you forgot, or you didn't notice that the address in the URL wasn't what you were expecting, and you went ahead and you signed in to the fake eBay or PayPal site that I've been using in my examples, then things get bad. Things can get really bad. As soon as you attempted to sign into the fake page, you've essentially handed over your login credentials to a hacker. Remember, the page, the fake page, has a place for you to enter your username and a place for you to enter your password, just like a normal sign-in page. But this time, when you enter them, and especially when you then click submit or sign in or whatever, it's the hacker that gets the data, not the real page. As soon as you realize that this happened, close the tab, visit the real site using a URL that you know or a bookmark that you've previously saved. For our examples, you'd explicitly type in paypal.com or ebay.com by hand and go to that site. Then immediately change your password. Review the account recovery information, if there is such a thing, for the account that's involved, and update anything that is incorrect or out of date. Remember, chances are when you give your information to this fake sign-in page, the sign-in's going to fail. It's just going to not respond. It's going to have an error. It's going to do something that isn't signing in. That's your first clue. Double check the URL that you're actually on. And if it's not what you expect, yeah, go plan to recover your account. Now, if when you get to eBay or PayPal or whatever, if you can't sign in to the real live account after having gone through this fake phishing sign in, the hacker has probably quickly and now successfully captured your account. They may have gone in and changed your password out from underneath you. Your account has been hacked. You need to follow the account recovery instructions provided by the service and try to get your account back. If you do, again, change your password and review all of the account recovery information that's in that account in case the hacker changed that too. Once you're in the account, you also need to review a few critical things. If the hacker downloaded copies of whatever is stored in your account, you need to consider how much of a problem that might be. There's no way to know if they actually did this, but you should be prepared. It could be as simple and as common as, say, downloading your contacts if they get into your email account. However, if your account has access to private data for yourself or for others, consider the possibility that this data is now in the hacker's hands. What you do next will depend on your situation. Check your account for emails you didn't send or transactions you didn't make or other activity you did not initiate. Particularly with financial accounts like our PayPal example, all the hacker needed to do was transfer money out of your account before you notice. The sooner you notice, the greater the chance you can recover. Also, review whether having access to the contents of this compromised account would alert the hacker to other accounts you have and what might be valuable in them. Your email account is often a gateway to many other accounts, including your financial accounts. For example, they might be able to see that you're using a specific bank. They could then go to that bank and perform an account recovery. I forgot my password. And therefore use the email address that they have access to basically change the password on this other account that they then have access to. You get the idea. Especially if your email account is the account you use for other sensitive services, you really need to be careful and check all of those other services and what's going on in your email account to make sure that the hack hasn't spread. Now, a lot of people worry about malware. Honestly, it's quite rare these days, but technically, yeah, accidentally clicking on a phishing link can sometimes maybe cause malware to be downloaded to your computer. Now, while that is serious, honestly, it's not something I worry about a lot. Normally, you'll get plenty of notices from your browser or your security software that either just that you're downloading something, or the security software might say, hey, you're downloading something malicious. However, if you suspect that this might be the case, then as soon as you realize what's happened, run a complete anti-malware scan using your security software to see if there's anything out of place on your machine. Hopefully, and honestly likely, nothing will turn up. However, bottom line, as you can imagine, is when in doubt, assume the worst. If you accidentally click on a phishing link and you're not really sure what happened, it's safest to assume the account in question has been hacked. You should take steps immediately to secure it, beginning with changing its password. And yeah, you should also run a full anti-malware scan using your security software because there's no harm in doing so. There's a really good chance that nothing will turn up, and that's good. But you still need to remain on guard for anything suspicious that might have resulted from clicking on that malicious link. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/132182. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.